One of my online kettlebell clients recently learned the Turkish getup, and that's what inspired me to create this post today. Today I'm going to completely break down the Turkish getup step by step for you. Hey, I'm Ryan Jankowitz, I'm a level 2 RKC, and I'm the owner of RJ Kettlebell, and I'm on a mission to help men and women get in great shape using kettlebells. So I'm going to break down each step of the getup. I'm not going to use a kettlebell, that way I can point things out and move around within the getup, and I'll completely break down every stage. I want you to keep in mind that I come from a hard style kettlebell training background, so my getup reflects that type of training. So let's start with the setup position here. I'm going to be doing a right-handed getup, so at times I'll be turning so I can look toward the camera. So if I'm doing a right-handed getup, what I want to do, actually let me start this way, is when I start on the ground, I start in the fetal position, my right hand will grab the kettlebell, and I have about a 90-degree angle in my elbow. My left hand comes over top to help. You never want to arm wrestle the kettlebell. So always start in the fetal position, and then roll over and use the weight of your body to move the kettlebell. And if the bell is light, you can use one hand to press. If it's heavy, I would recommend using two hands to press the bell. When my arm is vertical, I want to make sure that I keep my shoulder pulled down, and I'm actually squeezing my lat, and I'm contracting my obliques. I'm going to keep this leg bent, and then on the other side, let me turn here, I want to put my arm and leg out at about a 45-degree angle from my body. My next step here is to come up to my elbow, and then pause. When I come up to my elbow, I want to make sure that my elbow is underneath my shoulder. This will give me a nice base of support. I want to make sure I'm not collapsing on my shoulder, so I'm squeezing my shoulder blades together and pushing my chest up. At this point, my eyes are on my kettlebell. From here, my next step is to come up to my hand. I'm going to do that by slightly rotating my hand backward. So again, I want to make sure I'm not collapsing on the shoulder. I'm pulling my shoulder blades together, pushing my chest up. I'm looking at my kettlebell. My next step is to do a bridge. You can either do a low bridge with a sweep with the leg, or do a high bridge and then sweep your leg back. Do what's comfortable for you. So I'm going to do a little bridge, sweep my leg back. In this position here, I want to make sure that when I sweep my leg back, my hand, knee, and ankle are in one line. We don't want to leave this part short or go too far, which isn't very comfortable. That's hard to do, but a lot of people tend to leave that short. So get a nice line here from the hand, knee to ankle. Let me turn a little bit here. So at this point, again, my eyes are still on my kettlebell, and a lot of the weight's gonna be in this supporting arm. So what I wanna do is shift my weight into my hips, that'll unload my arm. So you should feel your core and hips engage, and then straighten up. And when I straighten up, I wanna look straight ahead, so I'm not straining my neck. From here, we can move ourselves into a lunge by taking this back foot, doing what's called a windshield wiper. So basically just put yourself into a lunge position or half kneeling position. If you need to, you can adjust your front foot, that's totally fine. Then from here, we do a lunge. So now we just reverse and do each step nice and slow. Lunge back, gently touch the knee to the ground. Then I'm going to windshield wiper my back foot in. Now when I come down here, I want my hand to trace my thigh and then move about a foot or so away from my knee. I still have that line from my hand, knee to ankle. And then I'm gonna load my arm. Now I'm looking at my kettlebell. Leg comes through, have a seat, come down to the elbow and onto my back. Make sure I don't hit my head. And then I can use two hands to pull the bell down and then roll and safely put the kettlebell down. So I know that's kind of a quick overview of the Turkish getup. There are a lot of fine points to cover. It really takes a lot of time to really master that movement. But I think if you slow it down and start with bodyweight getups first, it'll make it so much easier when you move to the kettlebell. If you have any more questions about the Turkish getup or kettlebell training in general, please send me a message. Stay strong.